Welcome to A Witch's Tale.
Welcome back, guys. Here, so the last part, I was pretty close to getting to a card battle. Of course, you guys know they're visible. So you probably know this too as well, that I put Jin up in the party as a permanent member, at least for now, because he actually has higher attack power and better defense than my other cohort, which he'll be in the background for the rest of the video game, because he has pretty much poor hit points at this point. And plus, Jin up can actually increase my defense, well, at least magical defense, when I use it, because Dana actually does the automatic physical defense between party members. So what I'm going to do now, after I feed these guys, there's actually an item called Open Sesame, which is kind of useful, but not necessary to get. And then we'll see that one. We'll be right back. I do apologize for the cut of the video, but there's actually another car battle just not too far from when I ended the first part there. It was just the scene, just around the corner. With that comes levels. So what I'm going to do, of course, is I'm going to continue, and there should be a mid-boss, like a scorpion mid-boss. And when that's done, I get the three items, and I can actually take it and form a key and proceed to the final area of this forsaken desert.
Thank you.
here's the boss level. Again, I placed Dan with Peso, because Peso did the healing. And technically, I left you up in there because, of course, without Dana to automatically defend the party, with the spell for a few rounds, Genop cast, Gary the lock of physical and magical defense. It's actually a pretty good combination, at least for right now. And since it's grubbing, okay, so there's the magic barrier, so I cannot cast any magic spells against them. But the one way around this, of course, I might mention in the past, is that attack them with a weak attack magic, you'll get hit, but the barrier will be gone, just like that. Of course, that wasn't very smart. But I don't have any weak attack magic against them. Now your gym has one. I think I has it right now, so it's taunt and the magical defense buff. But it's no big deal because I got Pacer right now to heal. Unfortunately, he's now paralyzed. The only way to free him is either, two ways to free him is either wait it out, hopefully disappears in time, that boss will kill me, or use the item that gets rid of it. now proceed to the final area. Again, I might mention before, there's really much to say about this game at this point. I could probably say something about the dialogue, but not much to say about it. I mean, some places are quick-witted, but at this point right now in the game, you're probably guessing what's going on. And as always, when you face enemies in castles such as this, where the final boss is at, they're actually quite hard, but they also give the most experience, at least in that particular world. So at this point, I have to be really careful. It's like the big boss, you know, can hit quite hard if I'm not careful. So at this point, when you're playing through before fighting the big boss, you should have two groups. One for attacking enemies, such as what I've got right now, and the other one is for attacking bosses. We also have to be careful that their levels are decent, so that way they don't get struck down with one hit. So I always try to make sure that your levels are not as low, especially when you go against bosses. Especially when at a certain level they get a specific spell, or in this case, buff. Fellowship of Boss coming up. It's worth knowing too well that the maze, you might guess in this particular castle, is that they're like gates, and once you go through a gate, you cannot go back from once you came, and it's pretty straightforward. So what's going to happen, I'm just going to defeat these enemies, and then I'm going to save before the final boss, and that'll be it. So it's worth knowing 24, I'll let this battle go, see you next time. And you guys, as well, as always, take care.